That's a million-dollar question, because SportPesa was funding the league. It funds the two biggest clubs in Gor Mahia and FC, as well as I think also the national team. But for me, it just shows you that our clubs have not innovated and looked at other ideas on how they can get revenues. Because someone told me a few weeks ago, what has stopped Gor Mahia and AFC coming together, like Real Madrid and Barcelona in Spain, to ask a greater share of the TV revenue, which in Spain is almost like 60-70%. I think the two clubs need to come together and see how they can get more revenue from TV. But back now to the big question at hand, I think most of the clubs are really going to struggle, because remember at 1.2 years ago, even Gor Mahia were not even able to pay their salaries for their players as they were winning the league at the tail end of the season. So what happens now without SportPesa? And that money from the TV revenue is a drop in the ocean. I think Gor Mahia, the allowances and I think salaries for a month, I think comes to around 5 million in a season. The league winner gets 4 million, which I think to me is a big joke. I think the league winner needs to get something close to around 12 to 15 million or 20 million in a year to sustain or to offset the costs which you get from salaries, allowances, traveling and other miscellaneous expenses. So we'll have to wait and see what happens, because as we now speak, the league has got no sponsor, the two biggest clubs have got no sponsor, and we don't know what will happen when we get now to the midway point of the season, if these clubs are going to survive. Gor Mahia is the team to beat by virtue of them having won the league for the last 2 to 3 years. I expect competition to come from Bandari. Let's see, also Sofapaka, also Kariobangi Sharks. Also, I expect them to be in contention. Which other team? AFC, depending on how they will start. But AFC, I think for me, are on the outside looking in. I think Bandari, Kariobangi Sharks, Madara United, and also Ulinzi, for me, will be the teams to watch this season, depending on how they're going to start. Because if you wind back last season, Madara started the league very well, but then at some point ran out of steam, ran out of gas, and that was the end of Madara United. And Goru had so many assignments playing in the SportPesa tournament in Tanzania. They were playing the Confederations Cup in Africa. All of a sudden, just got back together and they were able to run away with the league. So for me, Gor Mahia will be the team to beat this season. And if those three, four teams can start the season very well and be consistent, then they could give Gor a run for their money. But I still expect Gor to go all the way. And of course, we also can't rule out Tusker also, who are the last team outside Gor Mahia to win the league. So I would expect them also to be a title contender. And also Wazito FC, I mean, they have really splashed the cash, bought a sparkling new bus, they've signed players left and center. The question is, can Wazito FC's new signings now gel and put their performances on the pitch? Because on the outside it looks very shining, very glittering, but now it's the performances on the pitch which really matter. Let's see, Dickson Abundo from Gor Mahia, Kenneth Muguna from Gor Mahia. We also expect some of the new signings also from Wazito, Tusker also. To the team, so Sofapaka also sign. But for me, from what we have seen of Muguna and Abundo, especially when they beat the Burundian team in the CAF Champions League, I think those two players will really light up the league this season, and we should expect good performances from them.